We are going to start our problem with a rectangle with the sides of 12 and 9. Then we are going to pull the diagonal of this rectangle, and from this diagonal we will pull a perpendicular line to the left side of this rectangle. This line will be equal to the line segment of the height of the rectangle below its intersection point, as you can see on the sketch. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of this small red triangle? This question was presented to me by one of my subscribers, Michael_A. Michael wanted me to do this problem by using at least three geometric methods and without using trigonometry or analytical geometry. So this is exactly what I'm going to do. But before we do this, you guys can pause this video right now, tackle this problem for yourself if you want to, and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this problem together. So, I'm going to use three different methods to solve this problem. But before that, I will do some calculations that are going to be common for all three methods, so that I don't have to repeat it for all three methods individually. So let's do this common part first. We're going to start by labeling all the vertices of our rectangle as A, B, C, and D. Then we will label the remaining vertices of our red triangle as P and Q. Now, let's pull a line from a point B to point Q. In this way, as you can see, we have formed two right triangles, the right triangle QAB and the right angle triangle QPB. Now you can see that the line PQ is equal to the line QA, since this is the condition of our assignment. Next, we can see that the line QB is actually congruent to itself, and finally we can notice that the angles at the point P and point A of those two triangles are also equal, since those are right angles. From this, using the side-side angle theorem, we can conclude that those two triangles ABQ and PBQ are actually congruent. Now, furthermore, we can say that the lines AB and PB are equal, so this means that the line PB will also have the length of 12. Next, let's notice the right angled triangle DCB. We can use the Pythagorean theorem to find the diagonal DB, since DB squared is a hypotenuse and it is equal to the sum of the legs BC squared and CD squared. Now we can substitute our values, we can work through this, and we will finally get that the line DB must be equal to 15. Now let's notice the line segment DP. This segment can be calculated as the difference between the lines DB and PB. So we can substitute our values and get that the line DP must be equal to 3. Of course, this line will actually represent one of the legs of our red triangle. This will be the common part for all three methods. So I'm going to start each method with this sketch and these values that we just calculated. Alright, so let's first do the method number one, which will use the Pythagorean theorem. So first we will start this method by labeling the leg QP as A. Then we will use the Pythagorean theorem to find the hypotenuse DQ. So DQ squared must be equal to A squared plus 3 squared. We can work through this and get that DQ must be equal to square root over quantity of A squared plus 9. Then we can notice that the lines PQ and QA are equal. So this means that QA also has the length of A. Now, let's simplify our image a little bit and let's rearrange some lines. You can see that the hypotenuse of our red triangle and the remaining segment of length A must be equal to the height of our rectangle, which is 9. So, we will use this as our equation. We can work through this by first putting the A on the right side of the equation and then we will put everything to the square. From this, we will get the following. Now we can expand the right side of the equation by using the square of binomial and simplify a squared and finally get that 18a must be equal to 72, which means that a must be equal to 4. And if you remember correctly, a represents the other leg of our red triangle DPQ. So now it's pretty easy for us to find the area of this red triangle. Since this is the right angle triangle, its area must be equal to the product of its legs over 2. So we're just going to substitute our values, work through this, and get that this red area must be equal to 6 squared units, and we have our solution. Alright, so now let me show you the second method, which will use the triangle's area. So, we're going to start this method by first labeling the height of the red triangle PQ as H. Then we can notice another right angle triangle beside him, QPB. You can see that those two triangles share the same height of H. So we can use one really interesting triangle theorem, which states that if two triangles share the same height, then the ratio of their areas is equal to the ratio of their bases. And this is actually quite neat because we can use it in our two triangles. We can say that the relation between the areas of the red and blue triangles is equal to the relation of their bases, which is 3 over 12. So we can simplify this and cross multiply to get that the area of the blue triangle is 4 times the area of the red triangle. So let's label the area of the red triangle as A, which means that the area of the blue triangle must be equal to 4A. But if you remember, we already proven that the triangles PQB and QAB are congruent, which means that the area of the triangle QAB must be equal to 4A as well. Now let's notice the big triangle DAB. This triangle is actually the half of our rectangle. So this means that we can mirror this image on the other side and we will have the same areas. Now, from here, we can conclude that the area of the whole rectangle is equal to 2 times the sum of the area of red, blue, and light blue triangles. Then we can work through this and get that this area is equal to 18 areas of our small red triangle. Then we can also calculate the area of our big rectangle as the product of its base and the height, which equals to 108. Since both values are equal to the area of the rectangle, we can say that those areas are equal to each other, which means that our wanted red area must be equal to 6 squared units, and again, we have our solution. Alright, so now let's do the third and the final method, which is going to use the triangle similarity. And this method, I think, is by far the simplest one. Alright, so we're going to start by first looking at our red triangle, and specifically to the angle at the point Q. And we can label this angle as theta. Since this is the right angle triangle, this means that the angle at the point D of this triangle must be equal to the difference between 90 degrees and theta. Now, let's have a look at the big triangle DCB. This is also the right angled triangle. And if you take a look at the point D, the overall angle at this point is 90 degree angle. And since one small segment of this whole angle is 90 degrees minus theta, this means that the remaining acute angle at the point D must be equal to theta. Furthermore, since DCB is a right angled triangle, this means that the angle at the point B of this triangle must be equal to 90 degrees minus theta. So, since our red and blue triangles share the same angles, we can conclude that those two triangles are similar. And we can isolate them on the right side, and we will also position them so that they have the same orientation, so that you can clearly see what I'm going to do next. Then, let's put the values of the legs for the blue triangle and the value for the leg for the red triangle. Now we can calculate the remaining leg of our red triangle by using the rule of similarity. We can say that the relation between the legs of those two triangles must be equal. So, if we substitute the values from our sketch, we will get the following. Now, we can cross-multiply this and finally simplify to get that the leg QP is equal to 4. Now, with this, it's pretty easy for us to find the area of our red triangle. Since it is the right-angled triangle, the area will be equal to the product of its legs over 2. We will just substitute our values, simplify, and finally get that the area of our red right-angled triangle is equal to 6 squared units, and again, we have our solution. Alright, so I really hope you guys enjoyed this problem, and if you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel for more content like this in the future. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, do not hesitate to write it down in the comment section below. And again, as always, until next time, see you all and take care.